I want to recognize China for its central role as a pillar of international cooperation and multilateralism. New renewable energy jobs in China now outnumber those created in the oil and gas industries. In 2017, China invested over $125 billion in renewable energy, an increase of at least 25% over the previous year. And China's new cutting-edge transmission line that sends electricity along a pathway 600 miles longer than anything built today is a further potential boom for renewables. And we now, looking ahead, are aware that at least 75% of the infrastructure our world will need by the year 2050 has yet to be built. In moving forward, I would point to three very important opportunities that can be seized. First, the world will benefit from a Belt and Road Initiative that accelerates efforts to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals. Second, the world needs to take profit of the Belt and Road Initiative to help close significant financing gaps for achieving the Sustainable Development Goals, especially in the developing world. And third, I see the Belt and Road Initiative as an important space where green principles can be reflected in green action. Countries today not only require the physical roads and bridges to connect people and markets, they need roads and bridges from the unsustainable, fossil-fueled grey economy to a clean, green, low-carbon energy future. Fully expanding our policy options for green and sustainable development and backed by green financing instruments must become the new norm.